Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Seal, the High Level Queen, and if you have ever looked at the calendar section of High Level lately, you will notice there are a lot of new features, a lot of new types of calendars, and you may be feeling a little bit overwhelmed. So I want to show you how to set up all the different kinds of calendars and what the differences are in this quick video. So let's get started. Okay, so the first thing that you're going to want to do is make sure that all of the test features are enabled on your account in case you're missing something. So you're going to want to go to settings on the bottom left and click on labs. And here you can turn on time zone update, Outlook two-way sync. You can turn on all of the fun new things that have to do with calendars. And also, if you want early access to new features, this is the best place to get that access. So with that being done, we're going to head over to calendars. So I'm under settings and calendars, and I have five options here at the top: calendars, groups, service menu, rooms, and equipment. If you do not have these new items here, I'm going to show you how to turn those on. Click on preferences, account preferences, and make sure that you have enabled service menu, rooms, and equipments. You can also set the day of the week that you want to start on here, as well as a time format, language, and so on. So go ahead and click on save preferences and head back over to calendars. Okay, so before we create a calendar, I want to go over the tabs at the top and explain what they mean. So calendars, obviously this is where you're going to see all of your calendars. Groups, this is where you can kind of set up like a Calendly type of look, and it's going to show you like introductory call, second call, closing call, or you can have like a group for, let's say you have a spa, a group for pedicure, a group for massage. Then service menu, you're going to need the groups for the service menu later on. And then you have rooms, which is all the rooms that you're going to use for your business, as well as equipment, which are the equipments that you use inside of your business. So in order to set up a service menu, you actually need to create groups first. So in this example, we have a group of eyebrows with two calendars, a group of nails with two calendars, a group of hair with two calendars, and so on. And this is how you group your calendars. Okay, now if you click on create calendar, you're going to be hit with an overwhelming number of options here. The first one, service calendar. This would be something that you would use if you have a med spa or a gym or some kind of collection of services that you want to offer to your clients. The second option is a simple calendar. This is just going to be very, very simple like this, and it's going to be kind of like the Calendly view where you just have one calendar and one option and you want someone to schedule a meeting with you there. The third option is round robin. Round robin can be used for calls, support, sales, interviews. It's going to be something that you want to use if you have a team of people and you want to rotate through the team of people to set up appointments. So this is kind of what that looks like on the back end. You can either optimize for availability or you can optimize for equal distribution. Availability is first come, first serve, and you can set the priority here. So let's say that you have someone who's your top closer, you want to give them high priority, and then someone who may not be as good of a closer, you can give them low priority, or you can optimize for equal distribution, which is going to just alternate from one to the other with no priority given. The fourth option is class booking. This is a relatively new one, and this is actually going to be very, very helpful if you do webinars or if you have in-person classes where the ratio is like 1 to 20 or 1 to 40. You can actually set the number of people that you want in your class and assign them to rooms and all kinds of cool stuff. And then for collective booking, this is actually going to be a meeting where you want your team members to be available at the same time to meet with someone. And it could be for, again, support, sales, interviews, and so on. Let's say that you have three co-founders and you're doing interviews for a director and you want all three people to be available. This would be an example of a collective booking. All right, so now that we have explained the types of calendars, for simple calendar, this is super, super simple. You're just gonna click select, and then here you give your calendar a name. Then you give it a custom URL, which is just gonna be the URL that you want to look at directly. And we can embed this later so you don't have to actually use this link to give to anyone. Here you're going to set your availability, and we're just gonna keep Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. But if you wanna add days, you can just select them like this. And then meeting location, you're gonna put your Zoom link in here or a physical link. And you can also accept payments. You will have to have Stripe integrated to your account to accept those payments. You can hit confirm to save this calendar. All right, this is your preview link. Again, this is what I was talking about a second ago. If you click on the arrow, it's actually gonna show you what the calendar looks like. Super simple. And that one was the easiest one. Now we're gonna move on to a round robin. And we can just name it. Now here, you're gonna select your team members. And we're just gonna rotate between these people. Hit confirm. And that will create your round robin calendar. Now, again, you can hit the arrow and preview it. But that isn't exactly what we wanted to do because we're not done with that. I wanna show you how to set the priority. So if you go back into the calendar and edit it, or you click advanced options, you can set priority here, as well as a custom link, Zoom, Google Meet, phone, or full address. Right, so I haven't selected a Zoom account yet. I'm gonna show you how to do that right now, as soon as we save this priority. So go ahead and save the priority. In order to set up your Zoom integration, you're going to want to click on My Profile under Settings, and then this is where you connect your calendars and your video conferencing. So click on Video Conferencing and Add New, and here you'll be able to choose Zoom, Google, Outlook, or iCloud. You can actually integrate to all these calendars now, which is really, really cool. Click on Connect Zoom, and then once you sign into Zoom, you will be able to connect your Zoom account. You can use Google integration or just simply log into Zoom. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that and click on connect, and I should be connected to Zoom. Okay, one more step. After we have done this, we are going to click on connect Zoom here. Okay, after you add the Zoom integration, you should be able to just click on Zoom and it will start working. Now, quick note, each user needs to add the Zoom integration into their own account under My Profile, otherwise it will not work. You can see here it says they have not connected yet, so they will need to log into their account and then connect their Zoom there. Okay, now that that's done, you can set availability here. You can set the interval, scheduling notice, all that kind of thing here, and you can also add specific dates with specific hours, as well as a form, so you can add a sticky contact, which I always recommend doing, a consent checkbox, which is really, really important for A to P. You can also either have a confirmation message, which I don't recommend using, or redirect URL to send them after they book the appointment with you, which I do recommend using, as well as a Facebook pixel ID. So you definitely want to make sure you are flagging people that book appointment with your pixel, and that's where you do it. Also, make sure that this is checked, and then here's where you can turn on payments. And make sure that you're sending some kind of acknowledgement email, but I also really highly recommend allowing Google to send invitations to people, because that's just in case. And then here you can assign contacts every time an appointment is booked. So if you work on a commission system, you're gonna wanna make sure that you do that. And then you can allow or disallow reschedules and cancels. So you notice here, if I turn this off, it actually automatically removes it from additional notes, which is kind of cool. And here is where you make it pretty. So customizations, can be pretty robust now. You can do a cover image here. You can do a widget style. You can change the colors if you want. You can change the background color, button text, all the fun stuff here is where you're gonna do that. And then you can also insert custom code. So if you click preview widget, you can see right now my widget looks pretty boring because I didn't actually upload any pictures or anything like that. We're gonna go ahead and click on save. And then we can actually take the sales calendar and we can embed it into a funnel, website, etc. So it's actually really, really easy to do. In your funnel, you're just going to add a calendar element and select the sales calendar. All right, we've already talked about service calendar, simple calendar, and round robin. Now we're going to talk about class booking. Okay, so here is where you want to set your group. So if you have a class booking and you, let's say that you're scheduling a massage class, right? Make sure that you set up a group. You'll be able to select that there, as well as a team member and the invite title. Definitely make sure you don't just leave that like the default. This is pretty similar to the last calendar, but you do want to make sure that you set up your seats per slot, and you can either show that or not right there. In availability, you're going to want to set your seats per class because it's probably more than one. Go ahead and click on save. If you want to preview it, go back over to your calendars and click on share. Here you'll be able to get your scheduling link, your one-time link, or your embed code. So go ahead and just click on copy, open a new tab, and you can paste that in there. That is what the class booking looks like. You can see that I have 15 seats and 2 time slots available. Here I have all day available, etc. And this is based on your calendar integration. And the last calendar is a collective booking. So I'm just going to go ahead and open the collective booking that I already have here. And you can see that I have this collective booking tied to the sales calendar as a test. I have my custom URL in, and then here's where you're going to select your team members. Now this right here is where you change the owner of the calendar, which is basically going to just determine your meeting location. So if you have 2 people set up in the collective, only the owner can be tied to the meeting location. So it really just depends on how you want to set it up there, and make sure that you click save so that you don't end up crying in the fetal position because you forgot to hit save. Now I am briefly going to talk about rooms and equipments. I do have another video about how to create a service menu. So rooms are any location where you provide services. So let's say that you have a spa and you have massage rooms and you have 1 big pedicure room, or you have 10 small pedicure rooms, whatever you want to do there. You can actually set this up to tailor to that. So here in this example, I have a massage room with 5 capacity and I have a pedicure room with 10 capacity. All you're going to do to set up your room is really easy. You can just create a room here at the top and then select the name, description, and total capacity. Here's where you tie it to a calendar, which I highly recommend doing. Again, with the pedicure, you can see the same kind of thing. I have 10 capacity, and then I can tie it to a calendar. Then click on equipment. And equipment is like a special tool or device that you need to use to provide your services. So it could be like a machine, like it could be a laser. Let's say you do laser hair removal, like you have 2 machines, so you could do machine 1 and machine 2. Or in this specific example, I have 10 pedicure chairs and 5 massage beds here. So all you have to do is click on create equipment. And then again, you'll be able to select your total quantity as well as tie it to a calendar. And then when you link this equipment to your service calendars, the bookings are going to automatically reserve the required rooms and equipment. I hope this video helps you to set up calendars inside of HighLevel. Don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos from me, and get a link to a free trial in the description below, plus bonuses. I'll see you next time.